Hello there, this is Lynn Allen. Thank you so much for joining me for another AutoCAD tip courtesy of the fabulous Cadalyst magazine. I'm coming to you from Santiago, Chile, where it's actually quite cold. So that would mean that it is chilly in Chile. Oh yeah, I said it. So let's move along. So today I'm going to be sharing with you three different ways to put a boundary around your text. All right, three different ways of going about it. That's something that we end up having to do from time to time. So the first way is probably the most logical. Maybe not the fastest or the easiest, but by all means, there's nothing wrong with just simply going into the rectangle command and drawing a good old rectangle around your text, right? And of course, you can control the width of it, you can control the layer, so on and so forth. That's pretty basic. I'm going to undo that. Not very exciting. Makes it a little bit tougher for you to control the exact distance from the rectangle is from the text. Am I right? Okay, so let's go take a look at an express tool. That may not be very obvious because the name of the express tool is T-Circle, which makes you think it's only going to allow you to put a circle around objects, but in reality, it will let you do other things as well. Allows you to do rectangles and allows you to do slots around objects. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and select this text over here. All right. And you'll see that it asks you for an offset factor. I like that. That's a little bit easier than using the rectangle command. So I have complete control of the size of that rectangle that's going to go around my text. And then here you'll see, enclose text with circles, slots, or rectangles. All right, I'm in for rectangles, and I want the same distance all the way around it. And there you'll see that I very quickly, very easily now have a boundary around my text. Okay, that's number two. All right, the last one is for only those of you who have AutoCAD 2016. And it's kind of an interesting way of going about it. I'm going to go ahead and select this M text over here. And I'm going to go into properties, and you'll see if I slide this down that there is a new option inside of AutoCAD 2016 only in properties. Don't ask me how to get to it any other way. That allows you to say, you can see it showing up already, right? It allows me to say yes. And it will put a frame around my text, as it likes to call it there, a rectangle around my text. Do I have any control over exactly the size of the rectangle, how far off it is from the text? Absolutely not. I have no idea how to control that. But it is a fast and speedy way to put text, excuse me, to put a bounding box around your text. All right, so the trick there is you can't do it in the mText editor, you can't do it as you're putting it on the screen. You have to put text on the screen in your drawing file and then go into properties. All right, so that is three different ways to put a bounding box or a frame or a rectangle, whatever you want to call it, around your text. All right, so pick the one that's easiest for you to work with and does the job for you, and I will see you back here in 2 more weeks. Take care.